So I need to put the oranges all in a group and the apples all in. Hey guys, sorry I did not see you there. I am trying to organize some items here for counting, but I keep getting distracted. Have you guys ever been distracted or cannot focus when you really need to? I sure am getting distracted now with this silly robot wasp bugging me. Can you help me learn about organizing data so I don't get distracted? Thanks, let's take a look. Here is a question that asks, how many oranges are there? The question wants us to count all the oranges. To do this, we need to organize our data. In this case, the data we are talking about are the items you see here. Let's put all the same types of fruit together. Now we have all the fruit organized, and the question asks, how many oranges are there? Sometimes there is information in a math problem that doesn't help us find the answer. Instead, it can distract us, just like I got distracted by the robot wasp. We have apples, bananas, and oranges, but we only need to focus on the oranges. The bananas and apples are a distraction in this problem. Can you count how many oranges there are? We have 5 oranges. Great job! We organized our items and did not get distracted by the apples and bananas that did not help us solve the problem. Let's take a look at another problem. The question asks, how many more dodgeballs are there than baseball bats? This question has 3 categories or groups. We have dodgeballs, baseball bats, and fly swatters. Which group of objects do we not need to worry about in this problem? The fly swatters. Even though fly swatters are handy when pesky robot wasps come, they are not useful in this problem and are just a distraction. Let's move them to the side. We need to find out how many more dodgeballs than baseball bats. To do this, we can pair these objects together. How many dodgeballs are there that are not paired together? The answer is 2. Awesome job, guys! Let's try one more and see if you can tell me if there is a distraction in the next problem. The question asks, how many less butterflies are there than bears? Now that we have the problem, can you tell me if there is anything here that is not needed to solve the problem? We don't need the robot wasps to solve this problem. Great job! Now to solve the problem, we can match up the objects like we did in the last problem. We match them up and we notice there are 3 more bears than butterflies, but that also answers the question, how many less butterflies? We have 3 less butterflies than bears. There are 6 bears and only 3 butterflies. We did it! Awesome job! That pesky robot wasp is back again. I have a fly swatter, so watch out. Ouch.
You have a few options here. You can click the video on my right or on my left to watch more awesome stuff. If you want to subscribe, click the big red subscribe button below. You might want to hurry and choose though, because I can't hold on forever. Hurry, choose.
Uh-oh.